Welcome to lecture 5. In the last lecture we have derived the expression for frequency domain and the time domain expressions for FM wave if you are considering a sinusoidal modulation with Fourier series. So just recall the expressions what we derived in the last class. We have derived this FM wave in time domain for sinusoidal modulation by using Fourier series, and this derivation is at most important and it is worth for a 10 marks question. S of t for FM, what we derived is AC summation JN beta into cos of 2 pi into FC plus N FM t, and here where JN of beta represents Bessel function in mathematics, and you have seen how this Bessel function waveform varies as beta increases. And for this you took Fourier transform and you got the spectrum also. Actually the derivation was to derive the spectrum only. So this is the last but one step in the derivation. After this we have taken Fourier transform on both sides. So therefore we got like this. Spectrum S of f is AC by 2 summation JN of beta. Fourier transform of cos is delta of f minus bracket term plus delta of f plus this bracket term. Okay, whatever is there in bracket, same thing is substituted. So this is the last equation of the derivation of the spectrum or the frequency domain description of FM wave for a single tone sinusoidal modulation by using Fourier series. This is of 10 marks question. Now till here we have derived. From this we understood that there are two types of frequency modulation. One is narrow band FM and the other one is wide band FM. So if you expand this summation, whatever we got in the previous derivation, if you expand, we have to expand it from n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity. Keeping AC by 2 outside, by putting minus to plus infinity, you will get so many terms, n is equal to minus to plus infinity. I cannot show all the terms, so I have shown here for n is equal to minus 1. This is the term for n is equal to minus 1. And if you put n is equal to minus 1, j minus 1 of beta, that is what I have written, delta f minus fc minus 1 into fm, that will become fc minus fm plus delta f plus fc minus fm, n is equal to minus 1. So it becomes like this. Now after n is equal to minus 1, put n is equal to 0, j 0 of beta, that is what I have written here, j naught of beta into delta f minus fc, n becomes 0, so only you will get f minus fc, that is what I have written here, and then here also n is equal to 0, delta f plus fc, so I am writing here. Now after that you put n is equal to plus 1, so you will get j1 of beta delta f minus of fc plus 1 into fm plus delta f plus fc plus 1 into fm, that is what I have written here, and etc. You can substitute any values for n, integer values starting from minus infinity to plus infinity because of this limits. Now this is what we got for wide band FM, because for wide band FM we understood in the last class that there is no approximation. Whatever the n values is there in your actual derived formula, whatever n values is there, for all the n values if you sketch the spectrum, and that is going to give you the wide band FM. So for wide band FM I am sketching all the values of n. For n minus infinity to plus infinity, if you sketch all, you will get such a infinite number of terms you will get in the expression, and for that if you sketch the spectrum you will get like this. One spectrum you will get for n is equal to 0, amplitude is what of the spectrum, j naught of beta into ac by 2, that is amplitude, that is what I have written. At fc you have j naught of beta into ac by 2 amplitude. Why at fc I have to write a delta signal? Because here it is there, delta signal at f minus fc. F minus fc means you know that delta signal will come at fc point. There is one delta signal. And why I am writing this as a taller one? Because you know that j naught of beta is highest amplitude. J1 will be lesser than j naught of beta. J2 will be lesser than J1 of beta. That's why the amplitude is kept on decreasing. Only for J0 of beta, the amplitude is maximum. After that, the amplitude decreases. That is because of your Bessel function, what we have explained in your lecture number 4, the Bessel function diagram. Now, after that, if you put n is equal to 1, you will get this j1 of beta f minus fc plus fm. That's why I am writing a delta signal at fc plus fm. Similarly, you get fc plus 2 fm, and on the another side also you will get this fc minus fm here, fc minus 2 fm, fc minus 3 fm, and so on. So you should write these dotted lines. Those dotted lines represents, you can put any values of n. So if you put any values of n, then we are going to call it as wideband FM. Now, what is the bandwidth of wideband FM? This is your spectrum, no? Because I am writing it in frequency domain, it is a spectrum. From where to where your spectrum is present? Your spectrum is present from everywhere, minus infinity to plus infinity. So therefore, the actual theoretical bandwidth, the actual theoretical bandwidth of wideband FM is equal to infinity. The bandwidth of WBFM, wideband FM, is infinity. Wideband FM is infinity. Now, what is the meaning of NBFM, narrow band FM? Instead of taking all the values of N, we are going to approximate the values of N for only three values. We are going to put only N is equal to minus 1, 0 and then 1. That's all. We are not going to put any other values of n. Then how your spectrum will be there? From this, all the values of n spectrum, if you put only n is equal to 0, you will get only this term. And if you put only n is equal to minus 1, you will get only this term, this component you will get. And if you put n is equal to 1, you will get only this term. And all other side bands, we call this as side bands. All other side bands you will not get. Only n is equal to minus 1, n is equal to 0, n is equal to 1, you are going to get it for narrow band FM. All other values of n, we are going to neglect it. That is why it is called narrow band FM. For wide band FM, your beta values, How do you differentiate it as wide band and narrow band? That also we have explained in the last lecture video. When it is called as wide band FM, if the beta value is very much greater. And when do you call it as narrow band FM? If beta value is very much lesser. If beta is very much greater, we call that FM as wide band. If beta is very much lesser, we call that as narrow band FM. Now, for narrow band FM, as I told, only three values of n are retained. All others are neglected. So you will get only this component, fc minus fm. You will get only fc component and you will get fc plus fm component. Actually, you should get this fc minus fm component in the negative direction. That is what we explained in lecture number 4. But when you take magnitude spectrum, if you take magnitude, the negative spectrum will become positive. That's why I am writing a positive spectrum for lower sideband. This is your upper sideband, lower sideband. Actually, lower sideband for NBFM is in negative direction. But because I am taking magnitude of the spectrum, I am writing it positive. Okay? Now this is for beta lesser. Now what is the bandwidth of NBFM? Because you have taken only this as the approximation, the bandwidth will be from this point to this point is your bandwidth. So what if you calculate, if you measure FC plus FM minus FC minus FM, if you calculate, then what is the distance you will get from here to here? 2 FM. So bandwidth of narrow band FM, for narrow band FM, the bandwidth is given by 2 FM. Okay, and that is why we tell that narrow band FM looks similar to your standard amplitude modulation. We got the same spectrum for standard amplitude modulation. That is why we tell narrow band FM is same as that of standard amplitude modulation, except one. What is that one? This LSB spectrum is in negative direction for FM. If you do not take a magnitude, this LSB spectrum is negative for FM. But there in amplitude modulation, whether you take magnitude spectrum or you take without magnitude, this LSB is always positive there in standard AM. So that is only one difference between narrowband FM and your amplitude modulation. Now with this, we have to take the Till now we just revised whatever we explained in the last class, narrow band and wide band FM. Now the topic what we will discuss in this lecture is, we have to calculate what is the transmission bandwidth of the FM wave. Transmission bandwidth of FM waves. We have to discuss about the transmission bandwidth of FM waves. So the first point, there are two methods to find out the transmission bandwidth of FM wave. First method I will explain. That means there are two formulas to calculate the bandwidth of FM waves. First one I will discuss. So here you just saw that there are two types of FM. One is wideband FM and the other one is narrowband FM. So for wideband FM, for beta very much greater, then you are going to get the bandwidth, actually theoretical answer of the bandwidth of wideband FM is infinity. But for beta very much lesser value, beta stands for modulation index of FM. If that is very much lesser, then NBFM bandwidth will be equal to 2FM. So what is the actual bandwidth? The actual bandwidth is equal to what? The bandwidth of wideband FM plus the bandwidth of narrowband FM. That is the actual bandwidth of wideband FM. So what is that? The bandwidth of wideband FM? It is infinity theoretically. It is only theoretically. And bandwidth of narrowband FM is 2FM and substitute. So actually theoretically the bandwidth of FM wave, infinity plus anything will be equal to infinity. But this is only theoretically. So can the theoretical value of bandwidth will be equal to infinity in practical? No. So therefore this is only theoretical value of bandwidth of FM waves. So it cannot be infinity. So what I have to do, this infinity I need to change it to approximation. I have to take the approximation of infinity. Instead of taking infinity, I have to convert that infinity to approximation. How to convert? See, when will you get infinity for wideband FM? Bandwidth of wideband FM. When will you get wideband FM? Wideband FM is the condition when only for modulation index beta very much greater. So what happens if beta is very much greater? What happens if beta is very much greater? You know that beta is given by what? What is the formula for beta? Beta formula is delta F divided by FM. This is from the previous lecture video. Modulation index is delta F by FM. Then what is your, what happens if for the wideband FM? For the wideband FM, as beta increases, you know that for wideband FM, beta is very much greater, no? So if the beta is very much greater, that implies what? If beta is greater, delta F is also greater, no? So therefore, delta F is also very much greater, because beta and delta F both are directly proportional to each other. So modulation index is very much greater. That means delta F is also very much greater. So what happens as beta tends to infinity, then your delta F also tends to infinity. This is only for theoretical purpose. That is why you got the theoretical bandwidth as infinity. Now I have to approximate infinity. Instead of infinity, I have to take something else which is approximate to infinity. So what can I take? See, you know that this delta F is nothing but infinity. So instead of infinity, can I approximate it to 2 times of delta F? Can I approximate it to 2 times of delta F? Yes. Why? Because for wideband condition, beta is very much greater. If beta is very much greater, delta F is very much greater. What happens if beta tends to infinity? Your delta F also tends to infinity. So therefore I can call this infinity is nothing but, instead of only taking delta F, I am taking it as 2 times of delta F. That means why this 2 is multiplied? To make sure that 2 into delta F is approximately equal to infinity. To make sure it is approximately equal to infinite. This condition is valid only for wideband FM. Only for wideband FM you are going to take it as, instead of infinity, you are going to take it as 2 times of delta F. You understood why 2. Delta F is nothing but infinity. So infinity is approximated to delta F. Not only delta F, to make sure it is very very bigger value approximated to infinity, I am multiplying delta F with 2. That's all. So for only for wideband FM, infinity instead of infinity, I am going to take it as 2 into delta F. Now let us substitute this condition here. Now what happens? So therefore you are going to get the bandwidth. Therefore you are going to get the bandwidth as, instead of infinity, what is the approximation we made for wideband FM? We converted infinity to 2 times of delta F. We converted infinity to 2 times of delta F. Plus, this is for narrowband FM. That you cannot do anything, you write down as it is. So therefore, I got the expression for bandwidth of FM waves. The bandwidth of FM waves is equal to 2 times of delta F in plus 2 into FM. Now, this analysis is called as, this formula to find out the bandwidth of FM is called as Karzan's rule. This is very important with respect to the lab Viva question also, and in theory also. Explain the Karzan's rule of finding the transmission bandwidth of FM wave, they can ask. So the transmission bandwidth of FM wave is derived from the Karzan's rule. Karzan is a scientist who analyzed this expression and gave one formula to find out the bandwidth of FM. That is why it is named after him. Karzan's rule to find the bandwidth is equal to 2 delta F plus 2 FM. Okay, this is one method to find the bandwidth of FM. There is one more method to find the bandwidth of FM. This is the second method to find bandwidth of FM. See how to find the bandwidth. What is the spectrum you have got? The spectrum for the FM wave, you got it as S of F for FM. Magnitude spectrum, you got like this. There is one main band carrier at FC. After that you have so many side bands. Actually, theoretically, there are infinite number of side bands. There are infinite number of side bands, no? Okay. So, what are these called as? These are called as side bands. Also, these are also called as side bands. Both are side bands only. Now, what is this middle term at FC called as? It is called as unmodulated. It is called as unmodulated because it is present at FC. It's called unmodulated carrier signal. Unmodulated carrier signal. So how to take the bandwidth now? Actually, the bandwidth, because it goes up to infinity, the bandwidth is infinity. So, but I cannot take the bandwidth as infinity for practical purpose. So how to take the bandwidth now? See, let us limit ourselves. Let us take this amplitude as your Jn of beta. So let me assume this amplitude as some value. See, wherever the amplitude of this delta signal is greater than 1% of your this amplitude. 1% of the amplitude. So, for example, assume this amplitude of the carrier signal, unmodulated carrier signal, as 100. So, wherever you have greater than 1% of 100, what is 1% of 100? 1%, 1% of carrier amplitude. Carrier amplitude. Actually, it is 1% of the carrier amplitude. What is 1% of carrier amplitude? So 1% of, I am taking the carrier amplitude as 100. So what is 1% of 100? Which is nothing but 1 only, right? So wherever you have the amplitudes of the sidebands greater than this 1% of carrier amplitude. So that means you have to take the bandwidth like this. The bandwidth is equal to the distance, bandwidth is equal to distance from the amplitude, distance from amplitude of sidebands, amplitude of sidebands greater than 1% of unmodulated carrier amplitude. It should be 1% of unmodulated carrier amplitude. Okay. So your bandwidth is nothing but from here to here. By taking the amplitude of the sidebands should be greater than 1% of your carrier amplitude. So if the carrier amplitude is 100 and 1% of 100 is equal to 1, that means your amplitude of the sidebands should be more than 1. Wherever the amplitudes of the sideband is more than 1, only you have to take the bandwidth till there. And wherever the amplitudes of sideband is more than 1% of the carrier amplitude, you have to take the bandwidth only till there. So assume that here, after this, you will get less than 1% amplitude. The amplitude of the sidebands is very, very small. The amplitude is very small such that it is lesser than 1%. So here also the amplitude of sidebands is very, very small such that it is lesser than 1%. So I'm going to leave this. Now what is the bandwidth? From where to where you got the bandwidth? From here to here. So this is your bandwidth I'm going to take. So what is this bandwidth? So that bandwidth is nothing but the distance from amplitude of the sidebands greater than 1% of the carrier amplitude. Or you can also call it as amplitude of sidebands. Amplitude of sidebands should be greater than 1% of the carrier amplitude. So it should be greater than 1% means what? Should be greater than 1% means amplitude of the sidebands should be equal to in and around 99% of your carrier amplitudes. So this is called as the bandwidth. How to find this bandwidth? So the bandwidth is equal to, how to find this? What is the distance between one sideband and its next sideband? The distance is called FM, no? FM. So like that, how many FMs I have to take? From here to here it is FM. From here to here it is FM. And again here to here FM. Again here to here FM. The distance between one sideband and its next sideband everywhere is FM only. So FM, how many such FMs I have to put? This side and this side I have to put 2 times of FM. And how till what value you have to take that? You have to take only for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I have to take till 8. 8 is an example here in this case. So in general, let me call it is a integer value N max. Let me call it as N max. So the bandwidth formula for FM wave for the second method is bandwidth is equal to 2 FM into N max, where N max stands for, what is the meaning of N max means, how many sidebands I have to take. Here in this example, how many I have taken inside this window box? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 I have taken inside the box. So in my example, N max is equal to 8. Like that, in general, how many sidebands I have to take? That is nothing but N max. So N max is equal to number of sidebands. Number of sidebands having what? How did you take this these many number of sidebands? Because those sidebands amplitude is greater than 1% of your carrier amplitude. The amplitudes of the sideband is greater, 1%. Why did you leave the other things? Because the amplitude of the sidebands is very, very low than 1%. That's why we left. So n max means the number of side bands having greater than 1% of amplitude, carrier amplitude, greater than 1% of your carrier amplitude. That is your n max. Okay. So this method, this second method, the second formula to find out bandwidth of FM, the second method is called as 99%, and that is called as 99% bandwidth. It's called 99% bandwidth of FM wave. The name itself is called 99% bandwidth of FM wave. Okay. So there are two formula to find out the transmission bandwidth of FM wave. One is Karzan's rule, which is nothing but bandwidth is equal to 2 delta F plus 2 FM. And there is a second formula to find out bandwidth of FM called, the name itself is 99% bandwidth of FM wave. I told why it is 99%. And the formula for 99% of bandwidth of FM wave is bandwidth BW is equal to 2 FM into N max. 2 FM into N max. Now, they have given a curve. They have given a curve for bandwidth for the second method. They have taken the x-axis as beta and they have taken the y-axis as bandwidth divided by beta. They have taken it as bandwidth divided by delta F. Bandwidth divided by delta F. They are normalizing that, that's all. They are taking bandwidth divided by delta F. So this bandwidth divided by delta F, they are normalizing. After normalizing, they plotted that bandwidth versus beta. Okay, beta means modulation index. So as beta starts from 0 to 40, yeah, they marked this and they got the waveform. They got the waveform like this. They got it. They got the waveform like this. Okay. They took this bandwidth of the bandwidth formula of the second method. They divided that by delta F, frequency deviation. After that, they plotted the graph of bandwidth divided by delta F with respect to beta modulation index. As beta increases, the bandwidth divided by delta F, normalized bandwidth, kept on decreasing. So this graph, they called it as universal. They called it as universal curve for evaluating. This they called it as universal curve for evaluating the 99% of bandwidth of FM wave. So this you have to remember the curve, because based on this they can ask the problem. They can give this curve and they can ask you to find out what is the bandwidth of the FM wave. They will give this curve beta with respect to bandwidth and divided by delta F. By from this curve you need to calculate what is the bandwidth of FM wave. And this is universal. It is accepted worldwide. Everywhere to find out bandwidth of FM wave using second method, they are going to use this standard universal curve only to find the bandwidth. Is it clear? Now, so these two are the two methods you have to find the transmission bandwidth of FM waves. Now, one small topic is there. What about the power transmission of FM wave? Power required. What about the power required of FM? So what is the power required by FM waves? In our unit 1 amplitude modulation also, we have calculated power of the standard AM, power of DSBAC, power of SSBAC, BSB, everywhere we have found the power. So for FM waves, what is the power? Power depends mainly on what? Amplitude of the modulated signal. What is amplitude of the FM wave? For the FM wave, what is the amplitude? How does the FM wave look like? Sometimes low frequency, sometimes high frequency. Sometimes low frequency, sometimes high frequency. like this your FM wave looks like, right? What is the amplitude? Is the amplitude of FM wave varying? No. The amplitude of the FM wave is constant. Frequency is varying. So the amplitude of the FM wave is what? Same amplitude as your carrier signal. So the amplitude of FM wave is same as your carrier signal. So because amplitude is not varying, then what is the power? Power of FM is nothing but the power of carrier signal. So whatever the power of FM, whatever the power of a carrier signal you have, the same power of carrier signal is used by your FM wave. Why? Because whatever the amplitude of a carrier wave you have, the same amplitude is present for FM wave also. Amplitude is not changing. That is why power is also not changing. Whatever power carried by carrier signal, same power is also carried by FM wave. Now, can you tell what is the power for FM wave? Power for FM wave is nothing but power of carrier signal. What is the carrier signal power? We have done this in your amplitude modulation unit. So carrier power is nothing but AC square divided by 2R. So same thing is nothing but your power of FM wave. So therefore the power of FM wave is also equal to carrier power, which is equal to AC square by 2R. So all these formulas you need to remember. In the next video lecture, let us see some of the numericals about this FM wave, starting from our time domain expression, frequency domain, to calculate bandwidth of FM, to calculate power of FM, and to calculate frequency deviation, to calculate phase angle, to calculate instantaneous frequency. Many numericals of FM we are going to see in the next video lecture.